Hi, I am about to do a singing experiment, and I'm gonna try to relate some of the knowledge I've accumulated now that I've been experimenting with singing for about 10 years, since I was about in my early 60s. And I'm gonna sing that very well-known World War II song called White Cliffs of Dover, popularized by Vera Lynn, at about six different successive semitones, starting with the lowest, which is about seven semitones lower than Vera Lynn, who's a soprano, sings it, and the last one is about one semitone below where Vera Lynn sings it. That provides a pretty good sampling of where I probably sound the best, although I can sing it at least one semitone higher at Vera Lynn's pitch, and probably about three or four semitones lower. If you look at another video on this playlist called Experimental Stuff That I've Done, you'll see that I did time after time at over a whole octave, semitone by semitone, varying different approaches to it, which I called pop or opera. Anyways, this time I wanted to sing the song in a consistent way, or a fairly consistent way, because it's hard to be totally consistent over those six semitones for White Cliffs of Dover. And I decided, not to start too low and not to end too high. The first choice, I guess you could say rationally, had I done this totally rationally, which I didn't because I plucked around. But I'm assembling it rationally for you. The first choice is to see what the right approach is. Now you can sing it very operatically, which uses a lot of chest voice and which is very powerful. That doesn't suit this song. If I do it operatically, it sounds like this here. I'll sing you a little bit at one of the semitones. Now, you can also sing it like I did at first, non-operatically, but it's too morose. Sounds kind of like this one. Now that one, okay, I didn't use a hell of a lot of chest voice, but it lacked enthusiasm. And then I tried, of course, being enthusiastic. Now you can be too enthusiastic because this is supposed to be more of a hopeful song. It's in between the two and sound like somebody at one of those 1960 folk song pep rallies would sound something like this. Now that's good for some songs. I call that the chipmunk approach sometimes because the voice is too peppy, but it's good for some songs. So this one, you want it to be tender and not too pessimistic, hopeful. There's a range in there as well. When you sing it in a peppy way, you put your song way to the front of your mouth. And when you sing it operatically, you engage everything. It's powerful. It goes to the you get your chest voice and your head voice. But when you sing it sentimentally, as when you sing it in a peppy way, you want to concentrate more on your head voice, a sweet voice. A lot of folk singers sing a peppy way, and it's kind of a sweet voice. I'd wanted to avoid singing it in a blasé way, although you might find some of my versions maybe touching on that. It's hard because there's a fine borderline, or too low, like some of those old-time pop singers like Bing Crosby, Frank Sinatra did, which, I mean, I may not have them interpreted right. I apologize if I don't have it interpreted right. But you can sing it. Here, I'll give you an example. The singing sort of in my natural speaking voice.
There'll be bluebirds.
Then you hear that, to me, it may be lacking in resonance a bit. It's not enough in the sinus cavities, but it's pleasant and it has its place too. And some songs you want to sing like that. Other songs you want to sing operatically, like you'll find on this channel me doing Toreador from the Carmen opera. And that I sing right at the bottom, quite low in my range and operatically. And other ones I sing high in my range and operatically. It's easier to go high, sometimes operatically, or with that folk song approach. The operatic approach is good for opera, stuff that was designed when there was not microphones. And I sing that way too. You'll find some opera songs I've done here on this channel. Now that I've communicated a little bit of the wisdom, I guess you could call it, or knowledge that I've accumulated fooling around this hobby over the last number of years, realizing that I want to sound a certain way, which is more like violin sounds, which is really hard for me to get quite exactly. I mean, no, I can't even get it near how beautiful she sounds. I hope I sound pleasant anyways. I'm going to start with the lowest pitch, which is not too low, and then up it, there'll be five other versions, each one a semitone higher than the other. And I'll get to, as I said in the end, one semitone below where Vera Lynn sings it. And you could do me a favor if you want. Tell me, you know, chat message on the board or anyway, which one you think you like best. To me, I like them all. They all have their virtues. There's a couple that sound a little more morose in certain places than the others. I couldn't get it quite the same style. Other ones sound a little peppier and encouraging. Not much different, but you can hear the expression. And other ones sound smooth, a little smoother, but it's essentially the same approach here that you hear on each of these. So I look forward to your guidance, and thank you for listening to this long talk.
Tomorrow. must you wait and see? The shepherd will tend his sheep, the valley will bloom again, and Jimmy will go to sleep in his own little room again. There'll be blue.
Tomorrow, when the world
valley will bloom again, and Jamie will go to sleep in his own little room again. There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see. The shepherd will tend his sheep, the valley will bloom again, and Jamie will go to sleep in his own little room again. There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see. Just you wait and see. There'll be love and laughter and peace ever after tomorrow. Shepherd will tend his sheep, the valley will bloom again, and Jamie will go to sleep in his own little room again. There'll be just you wait and see. The shepherd will tend his sheep, the valley will bloom again, and Jamie will go to sleep in his own little room again. There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see.
There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of
shepherd will tend the sheep, the valley will bloom again, and Jimmy will go to sleep in his own little room again. There'll be blue.
Again, and Jimmy will go to